हेलो स्टूडेंट, माई सेल्फ दिगंत सखीवाला, आई एम योर साइंस सर। टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू चैप्टर नंबर 6, लाइफ प्रोसेसेस। इन दैट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न मैकेनिज्म ऑफ ब्रीदिंग। डियर स्टूडेंट, मैकेनिज्म ब्रीदिंग इन दैट टू थिंग इज इम्पॉर्टेंट। वन इज द थोरेसिक कैविटी विच इज कॉल्ड द चेस्ट कैविटी, ओके। सेकेंड थिंग इज द डायाफ्रैगम, दैट इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट, ओके। एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट रीजन इन द लंग्स, इन द आल्वियोली, द एक्सचेंज ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एंड कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड टेक प्लेस। एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट रीजन दैट इज अ प्रोसेस इन आवर बॉडी, इनहेलेशन एंड अदर इज वॉट एक्सहेलेशन अकर इन द बॉडी। सो स्टेप बाय स्टेप वी विल लर्न मैकेनिज्म ऑफ ब्रीदिंग। ब्रीदिंग इज अ कॉम्प्लेक्स मैकेनिकल प्रोसेस इन्वॉल्विंग मस्क्यूलर मूवमेंट दैट ऑल्टर्स द वॉल्यूम ऑफ थॉरेसिक कैविटी एंड देयर बाय दैट ऑफ द लंग्स, ओके। सो थॉरेसिक कैविटी इज प्रेस एंड थॉरेसिक कैविटी इज कॉल्ड द चेस्ट कैविटी, ओके। So when its volume is increase or decrease, it depend on that the exhalation or inhalation occur. Breathing occurs involuntary, but its rate is increase or decrease by the outward and inward movement of the ribs caused by the external and internal intercostal muscles, okay. So here it is a involuntary action. Involuntary action means it is not governed by us purposely. We cannot govern automatically it. Automatically it continue in our body, okay. So it is an involuntary action, as well as the rate is increase or decrease by outward and inward movement of the ribs caused by the external and internal intercostal muscles. So ribs, in that the muscles are there, and because of that muscles, ribs are coming outside or it is contract going inside, and because of that reason the expansion occur in or contraction occur in the thoracic cavity. This action is also assisted by the contraction and expansion of the diaphragm, and because of that reason the contraction and the expansion occur in the diaphragm. The floor of the thoracic cavity is completely closed by the diaphragm. It is the thin muscular septum separating the abdominal and the thoracic cavity. What is called the diaphragm? Diaphragm is what? Thin muscular septum separating the abdominal and the thoracic cavity, okay. The inhalation and exhalation of the air take place continuously in the respiratory system. So inhalation and exhalation will continuously take place in the body, okay. So now we will learn here about the what happen in the inhalation. Inhalation, in that whatever diaphragm are there, it pulls down, okay. Whenever it pulls down, because of that reason the surface area of the diaphragm will increases, and pressure of the air is decreases, and because of that reason air enter from your nostril and going into the lungs, means oxygen enter into the body. In the exhalation, what happened? It's pulled up, diaphragm pulled up, and because of that reason concentration of carbon dioxide is increases and it is going outside by the nostril. Inspiration or inhalation, it is a concern with the taking the atmospheric air or oxygen into the thoracic cavity, okay. So we take the oxygen in the thoracic cavity. How it is possible? When the inside the concentration of oxygen is less, air concentration is less, and outside concentration is more, then and then it is possible. During this the ribs moves outward. When we breathe, ribs move outwards and it moves upward, and the diaphragm contracts, and because of that reason what happens? Diaphragm contracts, so pressure of the air is decreases, okay. It pulls down, surface area is increases, and because of that reason what happens? Oxygen enter into the body. This reduces the pressure of the thoracic cavity and air rushes in. Now opposite thing happen in the exhalation. Expiration or exhalation, it is a concern with the expelling of carbon dioxide from the lungs, okay. So whatever carbon dioxide is collected from the different organ by the blood, that will expelled out by exhalation. During the ribs moves inward and downward, and the diaphragm relaxes, okay. This decreases the volume of the thoracic cavity and air is pushed out, and because of that reason what happened? Air is pushed out, okay. Hello student, we are going to learn about the exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide take place in the lung, okay. That how it will take place, that we are going to learn. Exchange of gases between the alveolar sacs and blood capillaries, okay. So first, blood rich in carbon dioxide, that is deoxygenated blood, enter the capillary network of alveolus. So from the different part of the organ, the carbon dioxide blood, the blood will contain carbon dioxide, is reaches to the network of alveolus, okay. and that blood not contain oxygen, because of the respiration process carbon dioxide is produced. Okay, so that blood contain more amount of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide diffuse into alveolar cavity because of its higher concentration in the blood. Okay, so carbon dioxide is diffuses in the alveolar cavity or cavity because what is the reason? That concentration of carbon dioxide is more in the blood, and cavity in that carbon dioxide concentration is less. Alveolus has higher concentration of oxygen as compared to the blood capillaries. So alveolus has the more amount of oxygen. Only reason is that by the breathing mechanism, more and more oxygen is produced. More and more oxygen is entered into the body. Okay, and because of that reason, the gaseous exchange take place. So inside whenever we take the breath, then inside the amount of oxygen is increases. Okay, and in the blood capillary concentration of oxygen is less. So because of that reason, oxygen entered from the higher concentration to the lower concentration. Therefore, oxygen diffused into the capillary and combined with the hemoglobin of red blood cell to form the oxyhemoglobin to be transported throughout the body. So what happened here, dear student? When oxygen enter into the blood capillaries, it combined with the hemoglobin, so it make the oxyhemoglobin, and it is going to the different part of the body. So when it goes to a different part of the body, then we feel relaxed. Okay, exchange of gases at the tissue level, internal respiration. So how, what happened in the internal respiration? We know that when the glucose burn in our body, then it make the carbon dioxide and energy. Okay, so amount of carbon dioxide is more there. Okay, in the cell, continuous metabolism of glucose and other substances result in the production of carbon dioxide and utilization of carbon dioxide. So by the metabolic reaction, the glucose is break down into carbon dioxide and energy. Okay, the concentration of oxygen in the cell and tissue fluid decreases while the concentration of carbon dioxide is higher than in the capillaries. Okay, so in the capillary, we can say that because of the respiration, carbon dioxide is more and more produced. So we can say that the concentration of oxygen in the cell and tissue fluid decreases while the concentration of carbon dioxide is higher than in the capillaries. Capillary, in that oxygen concentration is less and the concentration of carbon dioxide is more. Therefore, oxyhemoglobin breakdown releasing oxygen, which diffuse out from the capillaries into tissue fluid, that then into each every cell. And after that, what happened? Oxyhemoglobin is breakdown and releasing oxygen, which diffuse out from the capillaries into tissue fluid and then enter into the each and every cell. Okay, carbon dioxide from the cell diffuse out in the blood to be expelled by the lungs. Okay, so after that, carbon dioxide is expelled out. The breakdown of glucose to release energy by the utilization of oxygen by the cell is called the cellular respiration. So the breakdown of glucose by the use of oxygen, okay, and releasing energy, that is called what? It is called the cellular respiration. So this is all about the breathing technique, and other is exchange of gases between the alveolar sac and blood capillaries. Thank you so much.